Italy. I studied art and design, and I've been living in London for the last 4 years. I've been vegan since May 2012, after coming across a speech on the internet called "The Best Speech You'll Ever Hear." Just like a cold shower, it made me open my eyes to the world of animal rights. I didn't even know the word vegan before that, and I honestly thought that we had to eat animals and animal products to live. I thought that vegetarians had to take supplements all the time, and that's because I didn't know any real vegetarian. The only vegetarian I knew of was Lisa Simpson. I always called myself an animal lover, and as soon as I realized I didn't need to use or eat animals to live, I made the switch. I immediately felt passionate about animal rights. I started to sign any petition I could come across. I attended protests and demonstrations. I had countless arguments with friends and family, and I tried to do anything I could. But the more I went on, and the more I started to feel like anything I did wasn't making any real change. I wasn't getting any real response. So I slowly started to do less and less. I started to close up. I started to avoid mentioning it with anyone and cut short any conversation. And 4 years went on, and I never thought about joining my passion for art with my passion for veganism and use art as a form of activism. I've always been an artsy person. I've always been creating art since I can remember, from doing little arts and craft projects with my mom or nanny, or copying my favorite cartoon characters. And even though I moved to a career on graphic design for a while, I've always been drawing and painting on the side. So I was already an artist, and I was already a vegan, but I wasn't a vegan artist until May last year, 2016. That's when I came across the AgroCompassion Project. For those that don't know it, the AgroCompassion Project is a collective of vegan artists from all around the world, through various art projects, aim to promote the vegan lifestyle and support non-profit vegan organizations. So through the Art of Compassion, I started to find my voice for the animals. It resonated with me as a perfect way to share a message, to channel my feelings, and to support a cause that I cared about. Since I started last year, I had great feedback from both vegans and non-vegans. Friends and family came to me saying, I respect what you're doing, I've seen your drawing, great job. And I can see that it's making them think in a way that I couldn't achieve before. I attended some of the exhibitions that the Art of Compassion organized through the Veggie World Festivals, and I had non-vegans coming to me and say, this is more powerful than any of the talks or the screenings here. And I believe that in some way it's true, because art, it's inherently attractive and intriguing, and it can reach a whole variety of people, and it's harmless. So when we look at a piece of art, we are not only examining the artist's skills, but we're also trying to understand the different levels of meaning behind the subject, and we let the message sink in, and it can recall emotions that we didn't even know were there. So, because of all this positive feedback, I also find back my strength to get back out there and get out of my isolation mode. I started to do strict activism again, also thanks to the creation of education-based demonstrations like the Earthlings Experience and the Anonymous Board Voiceless Cube of Truth. If you are an artist here, I recommend you join the Art of Compassion Project. It's an amazing international community and it's a great platform to share your art and to share the message. Since its foundation in 2014 by vegan artist Leg Sanders, the Art of Compassion Project has, as I said, took part in a various number of exhibitions. We launched dining cards, art calendars, postcards, and all of the profits have been donated to organizations such as Viva, Veganuary, Animal Equality, and to sanctuaries like the Barefoot Vegan Sanctuary in France and the River Switch Sanctuary in the US. We are currently working on a coloring book and our own namesake book, which will feature interviews and images from all the amazing artists that are part of the project. If you are a vegan and you haven't found your voice yet, I'd say ask yourself, what is your passion? What is it that you're good at that you could use to help further the cause? We all have our strengths and our talents, and we can all use them to help. Or you might join an organization or a group or an initiative that you admire, that you get involved with. There are so many things that you can do. We all have the duty to act and to always strive to do more. The animals are being tortured and killed every second. The planet is being destroyed as an animal agriculture. There are a countless number of people that have no idea of the benefits of a vegan diet and might be affected from diet-related diseases, and we all need to do the best we can. Together, by joining all of our efforts and all of our talents, we can all make a difference and we can all change the world. If you're not a vegan, thank you for being open-minded, for being here. And I hope the exhibition here helped you to question some things and inspired you to make a change and make the right choice for the animals, for the future of the planet, and for yourself. Thank you.